In grammar, E can derive T E dash. E dash can derive epsilon slash plus T E dash. This T can derive F T dash. And this T dash can derive epsilon slash star F T dash. And this F can derive ID slash opening bracket E closing bracket. Assume we are having the following grammar, and for this particular grammar we need to find what is the first and we need to find what is the follow. Okay, and this grammar is finding the first and follow for this grammar is the most difficult task. If you can find the first and follow for this particular grammar, then you can find first and follow for every possible grammars. Okay, so the first of E, we already done this example. The first of E can be ID and it can be opening bracket. Why? Because this T can be replaced by F, F can be replaced by ID or opening bracket. Okay, now what is the first of E dash? For first of E dash it is epsilon and plus. What is the first of T? First of T can be ID and opening bracket. First of T dash is epsilon and star, and first of F is ID and opening bracket. These are the first. Now we need to find the follow. See, follow, for this follow, first of E is a start symbol. Follow of start symbol is always dollar, right? Now, can there be anything apart of start symbol? Yes. In the process of derivation, can we have anything which is following E? You can see if in this production number 5, this is production number 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. In this production number 5, E is followed by a closing bracket. That is why the follow of E is also closing bracket. Okay, next is E dash. Now see, if you want to find the follow of E dash, first of all see in the right hand side of all the productions, what are the locations where we have E dash. So here we have E dash and here we have E dash. Now because here we have E dash, now the follow of E dash is because nothing is after this E dash, therefore follow of E is also the follow of E dash. Hence the E dash will also be containing dollar and closing bracket. Is there anywhere else we have E dash? Here we have E dash. So whatever the follow of E dash, that is also follow of E dash recursively again. Now if you want to find the follow of T, to find the follow of T, check in the right hand side of the productions, what are the locations where we have T, right? So here we have T and here we have T. Okay, these are the only two locations where we have T. Then after this T we have E dash, after this T we have E dash. So whatever the first of E dash, that will be the follow of T, right? Again I'm saying, whatever the first of E dash, that will be the follow of T. Now this first of E dash is containing epsilon as well as it is containing plus. There is no problem with the plus. The first will be, follow will be plus, but this epsilon cannot be there in the follow. That means if we replace this E dash with epsilon, if we replace this by epsilon, so this can be removed. Hence, so T will not be following anything. If T is not following anything, then the follow of left hand side will become the follow of T, because this essentially, if you are going to replace this one, then this production will become E drives T. Therefore, the follow of left hand side, that is follow of E, will become the follow of T. Again, here the follow of E will become, E dash will become the follow of T. The follow of E dash and follow of E both are dollar and closing bracket. Hence the follow of T is plus dollar and closing bracket. Okay, don't worry, you'll get it by the end of this. If it is kind of difficult to follow in the first in the beginning, again it will become very easy. Don't worry, follow these videos. Now next we have T dash. Now you can see, if you want to find the follow of T dash, then you have to see in the right hand side of all the productions what are the locations where we have T dash. Here we have T dash, here we have T dash. Now because here we have T dash, now whatever is because there is nothing after T dash, so whatever is the follow of T, that will also be the follow of T dash. Hence it is plus dollar and closing bracket. And here we have T dash, but the left hand side is also T dash, so there is no problems. Okay, now we have the next symbol, which is F. We need to find the follow of F. Now you see, what are the locations where we have F? What are the locations where we have F? In the right hand side of all the productions, here we have F and here we have F. Now what are the variables which are following F? The variable which are following F is T dash, and here we have T dash. Therefore whatever the follow of T dash, that will also be the follow of F. So follow of T, I'm so sorry. Here after f we have t dash. Therefore, whatever the first of t dash, that will be the follow of f. That is first of t dash will become the follow of f. So first of t dash is containing epsilon and star. So we can write star, but because there is an epsilon, therefore that means this t dash can be replaced by epsilon. This t dash can be replaced by epsilon. That means whatever the follow of t, that will also be the follow of f. And here whatever the follow of t dash, that will also be the follow of f. The follow of t is containing plus dollar and closing brackets. Hence, the follow of f is star plus dollar and closing bracket. So these are the follow of all these productions. Okay, don't worry, let me take more examples and this will be very clear by the end. Assuming that we have one more grammar, the grammar is like this: S can derive opening bracket L closing bracket slash A. We have L can derive S L dash, and L dash can derive epsilon slash comma S L dash. Now again we need to find what is the first and follow of these productions. We need to find what is the first and what is the follow of these productions. Okay, now you can see for S, the first is opening bracket, or it can be A. For L, the first can be given by S itself, right? So the first is opening bracket and A. For L dash, the first is epsilon, or it can be comma. Okay, then we need to find the follow. The follow of S, that means check in the right hand side, in any production is there S? Here we have S and here we have S. Now in the right hand side of these productions we have S, and after this S we have L dash. Now whatever the first of L dash, that will also be the follow of S. So first of L dash is comma, right? And it is containing epsilon, but epsilon can never be in the first. So that means if it is containing epsilon, therefore if with this production can also be written as S, because L dash can be replaced by epsilon, and this production can also be written as L dash can derive comma S, because L dash can be replaced by this, right? So whatever is the follow of L, that will also be the follow of S. Whatever is the follow of L dash, that will also be the follow of S. Now follow of L, now you can see here we have L. The follow of L is closing bracket. And you can see right so here we have a comma closing bracket, and because it is a star symbol S, so the follow is always dollar. Got it? So now let us look at the next symbol, which is L. Now for this L we have what are the right hand side where we have L? This is the only place where we have L in the right hand side. So after this L, the only symbol which is following is closing bracket. Okay, now for L dash, what are the right hand side where we have L dash? This is the only locations where we have L dash. So if in the right hand side we have L dash, but after this L dash there is nothing, so whatever the left hand side, the follow of left hand side will be the follow of L dash. So it will be follow of L is closing brackets, therefore this is the follow. Okay, so got it? What is the first and the follow? See, don't worry, when I'm saying first and follow, that means in the process of derivation, what are the symbols which can follow a particular variable? Okay, don't worry, let me take one more example to find first and follow.